Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. So today I am just going to do a kind of haul slash first impression of some stuff that I've kind of already had for a while, and I'm going to give you guys my feedback on it. And please excuse the bun and the t-shirt. I'm just kind of doing a relaxed, chill kind of video. By the way, happy Easter everybody. Today is Sunday and it is Easter when I'm filming this. Should be up later tonight, but if it's not, happy Easter to everybody. I hope everybody had good time with friends, family, just enjoying people and relaxing and just enjoying your day, because that's what you're supposed to do. So let's just get started right on into this video. So the first thing that I have that I know is always sold out and everybody loves it, if you aren't on the Morphe bandwagon, then you need to hop on it because it's absolutely amazing. So what I'm going to show is my Morphe 350 palette, and it looks just like this. And I might have already hauled this, but I don't think I have yet. But I think that was on my old camera and I was trying to haul it, but it didn't work out. Anyways, besides the point. So this is the palette and it is absolutely 100% worth every dollar. It's only $22. All of their palettes like this are only $22, and their normal eyeshadows I believe are like $2.99, $2.29, something like that. And then their premium eyeshadows are $5.99, I believe. But I literally love this palette. It's all warm shades, so it's like perfect for any day, every day. So this is something that I definitely love. Another new thing that I got that is within, not eyeshadow, but it's the Naked by Urban Decay, the Flushed palette, which looks like this. And this, it has a bronzer, highlight, and blush all in one, and this is actually really fabulous. And I think it's only like $38, and usually that's the price of just a highlight, so it's really good and it's really worth the money. And it does come in a light skin tone and a darker skin tone. For those of you that are a darker skin tone, it does work for a lot of people. The next thing that I actually saw on Kathleen Light's YouTube channel, she had gotten these, excuse me, they're extremely dirty, I probably should clean them, but whatever. The first one is the Wet n Wild Illuminating Palette, and for some reason the one I got is always so hard to open. I don't know why. Ah, there we go, jeez. But it looks like this. You guys can see that. It is super pigmented, and I'll swatch it for you right here. I'll swatch the two lighter shades, and you can definitely, like, you guys can see that. You kind of can't see the lighter shade. Let me do the gold one. So the gold one is right here, and then right here is a lighter one, and then this is, like, the rose gold. But they're all really, really, really pretty. They go on really well. They stay all day, so it's definitely worth the money. I think they're $5, so I mean, why not, right? And the next thing is their contouring palette, which looks just like this. It comes with the banana powder and then the bronzing contouring. This is amazing. I will have some feedback on it though. One negative thing, so it looks like this, and these are both really pigmented. Let me like rub off the, forgot to get makeup wipes, but I mean, those are the pigmentation, and that's just like with one swipe. So really pigmented, for especially Wet n Wild, like I said, it's $5. Marc Jacobs makes this exact same thing, and I think it's $55. So this is good. The only thing that I have to say is I do not like the banana powder. The way that it sets in my T-zone, it just breaks up my makeup. It doesn't really like hold it together, so I will always use my Lorac for that. But the contouring, it is really good. That I do recommend. Okay, so the next thing that I got, also saw on Kathleen Lights, is this Physician's Formula Butter Bronzer. And this, it's great. So it looks like this. This is the top part of it. And then, like she says, it smells like the beach. And then you flip this open, and you get a mirror and a little compact brush. I don't think I would ever use this because it's a foam, so I don't really know how that would work, but hey, if you can get it to work, by all means. But this is really nice and it's really pigmented. Like, if you can see that right there, it's not dark by any means. They do make a darker shade of it, but I didn't want to go darker just in case. Maybe in the summertime I could go darker, but not right now. The next thing that I got is this NARS, and it's their eyeliner, and I've heard a lot of people rave about this, and it is literally all it's cracked up to be. It's so good. It never leaves my waterline. Like, let me just, like, it never leaves my waterline, so it's amazing. Let me just zoom in and show you guys. So I did my makeup this morning, and I mean, look, I don't have any smudges here. I don't have anything here, and it is 6:30, and I did my makeup at 10 o'clock this morning. So, I mean, it works really well for me. Okay, and the next thing that I got, actually, let me stay with Wet n Wild really quick. So Kathleen Lights had talked about this brush particularly right here. Looks like this. And their brushes are really, really, really soft. Like, I will have to give them that. And I think this brush was $1. It's like e.l.f. basically. But it's really good quality for the cheap amount of money that you're spending on it. And the next thing that I got is by Becca, and it's the Champagne Pop highlighter, which is right here. I've gotten mixed reviews on this. Some people say that it's really gold for them, which, I mean, to each his own, but for me personally, I absolutely love this highlighter. I mean, just, like, look at that pigmentation. And when it goes on, I mean, it's crazy. I love it, and I pack it on because I love highlighters. So this was definitely worth the money. I've used it just about every day since I got it, so that is definitely worth the money to get. And the next thing I got recently is also by NARS, and it's their NARS Creamy Concealer. This is really well, and it works really well for me. Like I had said, in my foundation routine is I have Lancôme. I'm just using it to get, like, rid of it. It's not all that it's cracked up to be. It's really expensive. I think it's like $32. So, I mean, I wouldn't buy it again. So, and the next thing that I got that's new for me is the Smashbox primer for your eyelashes. And this is really great. I literally just put it on, just like a thin layer, and then I put on my mascara after it. It's super simple. Doesn't really require, like, any knowing of makeup, like, highly. So it's pretty good. I like it a lot. So the next thing that I got, and I actually waited to get this because I wasn't sure if, sorry, I'm, like, moving my leg. So I wasn't sure if I was gonna like this because I have so, like, everybody, I have so many nude palettes, and I wasn't sure if I wanted to get this particular palette I'm about to show you because I didn't think that it would be worth the money per se, because I do. So I'll just tell you what it is. So I got the Tarlet in Bloom recently, and it looks just like this. And it is really all it's cracked up to be. I mean, I love Tarte's eyeshadows. I have their holiday collection, which actually I haven't used in a while, so I might do a tutorial on some of those coming up. But it came like a let me see if I can find it on my phone to show you guys. Pause. Hold on for a second. So it was the Tarte Christmas collection. We'll start with that. Okay, the Tarte Greatest Glitz. I don't know if anybody got that over the holidays, but I did because I really wanted it. So let me see if I can get a good image and I'll show you guys. Okay, here we go. So I don't know if that's good enough. I'm gonna be picky about it. I guess I'll just show you two different. Okay. Let me save this image. And then I'll show you the other one after it. Sorry for me being like all up in my phone. I'm really not trying to be, but. Well, of course, that first one didn't save. Okay, let's try this again. While we wait for my phone to load. Okay, so this is what it looks like. Let me try and like zoom up as close as possible. So those are all the shadows. So it comes with shadows, and then down at the bottom is a blush that comes with each one. And then it comes in a really cute box, and it came with their like a color, like a lipstick, and it came with their mascara as well. And it came in like this cute glitterized box, and I think I want to say it was only like $50. Oh, here's a picture of it at the time. So it came in like this glittery box like that, and you flipped it open and there were tarte eyeshadows. Anyways, I'm really getting off the point here, but I loved all of those eyeshadows, so I was like, oh, do I want the Tarte Light and Bloom, because I already have so many neutral colors. But it literally is. It's Tarte is absolutely one of my favorite eyeshadows. They're so pigmented, they don't have any fallout. They just go so seamlessly on your lid. So if you're one that's just starting with makeup and you're not sure what palette to go with, I would definitely highly recommend the Tarte Light and Bloom or any Tarte palette. It's fantastic. I love them. Okay, so moving on. The next thing that I have to show you makeup-wise, because the last two things aren't makeup-wise, is I actually just picked these up yesterday. I put them on my lips, and they're okay for the money that they are, but I don't think I'm gonna buy any more. So I got these little e.l.f. lipsticks, and this is the first one. It's like a nude, and I'll swatch it for you guys. So this is the nude. And it does go on the lips fairly nice. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, it looks nice. And so the other one that I got, because I'm really into like mauve-y colors, I got this one, which looks just like this. And this one I'll swatch for you as well. It doesn't show up as good on the hand as it does on the lips, but that is this one right here. So those are really pretty as well, but I don't know, I just don't think that they would stay throughout the day. I'm really into liquid lipsticks. They're my favorite. So I don't think that I'll ever really like just a normal lipstick. I hate lip glosses. I don't like stickiness. I don't like having to constantly reapply. That's why I like liquid lipsticks so much, because they stay. You might have to reapply a little bit here in the inner part of your lips, maybe once or twice throughout the day, but that's it. So moving on, I got one thing for skincare. And it's this right here. It's the Exuvience Soothing Toning Lotion. And I have down below, I'll link down below, I have my skincare routine. And this is now added to it. And I told you guys that if I added anything to my skincare routine, that I would tell you. I am going to be getting their, they have a peel. I forget what it's called. Maybe I'll link it down below if I can find it. But I buy all of my Exuvience stuff on Amazon because it's so much cheaper. If you have Amazon Prime, do not buy Exuvience at Ulta. Don't do it. It's so much more expensive. That soothing toner, I think, is like $25, and I got it off of Amazon for $20. The Bionic Tonic, I think, goes for $75 at Amazon, and I get, or $75 at Ulta, and I get it for $50 on Amazon. So you're gonna save yourself a lot of money if you're wanting to know about skincare, because I know a lot of people are like, oh my gosh, I love your makeup. How do you get it so seamless? And I'm like, skincare. You have to care for your skin before you apply all of this stuff on top of it. Because if your skin underneath is irritated or not as healthy as it should be, when you apply everything on top of it, it's just gonna irritate it and it's not gonna make it any better. So that's my note to anybody that's like, oh, I need my skin to look better. Skincare, skincare, skincare. Spend the money on skincare. If you don't want to spend the money on makeup, spend the money on your skincare. It will forever be your savior, I promise. And the last thing is this brush bath by, I don't know why I took the cap off, by It Cosmetics, and it smells really good. It's kind of like a, I don't know, eucalyptus, I almost want to say. Kind of like that. But it looks just like this. And you literally, so I kept this brush semi-dirty to be able to show you guys. So you see how it has brown? These are pink bristles. So that is supposed to be pink. But regardless, it's a little bit brown. So all you do is you literally just take this. And it smells good, so it just helps. And you literally just like brush it off. And I'm always anal about it and I just do it twice. Sure, it's totally not necessary, but I'd rather be safe than sorry. And it doesn't, like, your brushes don't feel wet. But I mean, look at that now. Now it's 100% pink, 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 pink. Pink and white. And it's as easy as that. So, like, if you clean your brushes, because that's another thing. If you have irritated skin and you're wondering why, it's because your brushes are dirty and bacteria is sitting on your brushes. You have to clean your brushes. I know it's a pain in the ass, but you have to clean your brushes often. And so if you don't, like, say you have an eyeshadow and you're dipping into black and you're like, oh crap, I need the same brush. Like, say it's like your blender brush and you need the same brush for like a lighter color. You can just spray that on there, wipe it off, and you don't have to worry about the black transferring into the other color that you're putting on, if that makes sense. So that is really all that I have right now. I will be purchasing in full size the Makeup Forever Ultra HD stick. I plan to get that tomorrow, actually, because it is great, so I do plan to get that. But if you guys want to see like anything in particular, if you're wondering about anything, if I'm wondering about it too, I'll be more than happy to go out and buy it to like kind of give you guys a first impression. I'm gonna be getting some things that I will be doing reviews on for sure, because I plan on getting the Sweet Peach Too Faced palette when it comes. It should be coming next week, I believe. Next week it comes to Ulta and Sephora. So I'm going to pick that up. And then I'm also on the watch for the Benefit Cheekathon, which comes with 4 full-sized cheek blushes, a highlighter, and a brush. All full-size. So I do plan to get that. I think it's like $58 is what it's going for, and it's coming out in April because Nicole, I was watching her videos, and she's already got it. Lucky biatch. But I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. It was just kind of like a hangout, chill, nothing too drastic. Just showing you guys some things that I've gotten and my opinion on them, if you care about my opinion. So I will be doing some more tutorials probably in the next week or so. Once I can kind of get down with my routine of like editing and filming and everything like that, I'll have more of a routine when I'm going to upload videos. I'll probably do like Fridays and Sundays, or like Saturdays and Sundays for right now, since I do work in the middle of the week and my work is pushing mandatory overtime right now, which, hey, can't complain. I got a job and I've got money, so can't complain there. So I'm just going to have to like work around it. So and I have noticed that with my camera between the last two videos that I taped, between 4 and 6 is the best time for me to get the best like lighting. So that's really good that it's staying lighter, darker, so, or lighter, longer. So because right now it's like I said, like 6:43 and it's cloudy and my camera's doing well. So anyways, let me stop rambling. I'm sure you guys are like, come on bitch, hurry up. Okay, so I hope that you guys, again, enjoyed this video. If you like my videos, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to subscribe, or I hope you want to subscribe, please subscribe to my videos. And I will see you guys in my next one. Bye, guys.